somebody. And then he doesn't show up. Is she on the phone? You feel that water that comes coming out? Right there?
Hey, Kyle, see? I'm glad you're here.
Yeah. Good morning, Mr. Wallace.
What was that?
That's what everyone should say.
That's what everyone should say?
Yeah, when you walk in, everyone should say, good morning, Mr. Wallace.
Okay.
Oh, geez, yeah.
What you looking for, Ryan?
This is the other one. Everyone has a valid exact same time. You have to sit down and button and take the seat at the same time. And you can't squat. So I can sit like this.
Put away cell phones, guys. We had a wonderful morning. I want to keep it going. We did an SIV that just blew my mind this morning. You guys know who Jennifer McGrath is?
I don't know.
Ring the bell.
Is she what?
I think Park.
Yeah, that's not right here.
Died.
Yeah.
She drove a lot of it. The SIV this morning was awesome. We talked about quantum mechanics. We talked about atoms, yeah, we talked about molecules. We talked about the beginning of the universe. We talked about where the universe is coming. We talked about all the possibilities. God, the Big Bang. We talked about multiverses. It was awesome. Absolutely awesome. I loved it. Can you take off the other headphone? I want you guys totally engaged.
No, I can still hear you.
Hey, Mr. Wallace, how's Libby doing? She's doing great. No problems? None whatsoever.
I told my mom that you said that to me yesterday. I know where you get it from now. She was like, excuse me?
You can't tell her things like that.
I did, but she was laughing, though.
Okay, yeah.
She was like, I'm good, Mr. Wallace.
She's a lovely lady. I really enjoy talking to your parents. Your dad's freaking
fun. When I said that, she's like, get what from? I'm like, my attitude. She's like, oh, okay.
What'd you have to eat last night?
There's a little story about what I had last night.
Hold on. Those of you who are listening to music, do you have at least one earbud or headphone out? Okay.
So, I go into the kitchen before me and my mom leave for Pilates, and I'm like,
what? I'm listening. You're the one interrupted.
Yeah, Ms. Wallace.
Oh, you're gonna set it up for me.
So,
you don't have to cop
so
it out.
So, I go into the kitchen, and I see my mom is cooking fried rice. And I was like, oh, okay, that's for dinner. Like, in my head, I was like, just the fried rice is for dinner. And so, when I get home, my mom has another, it's like a big casserole.
Wait a minute, hold this up. You went into the kitchen, but then you left home.
Yeah, for Pilates, me and my mom.
Gotcha.
And then, so when we got back home, dinner was ready, because we were all ready to pay. And so my mom pulls out this big casserole dish, and she cooked a whole chicken, and then she's all like, oh, the fried rice is a side dish. Fried rice is not a side dish, it's a meal. Do you get me?
Here's what I'm hearing. It sounds like you were kind of frustrated with your mom.
Yeah, because she cooked the whole chicken.
Okay, now, but I see it as you're getting both chicken and fried rice. I would be like,
No, the thing is, me and my dad thought it was just fried rice for dinner. And then she had to cook a whole chicken.
Did you have chicken and fried
no,
rice?
No, I just had fried rice. I only ate the fried
oh,
rice.
Oh, you only ate the rice. Did you like not eat the chicken because you were mad at her?
No. I just didn't
eat, you only
I
wanted
just didn't eat the chicken. I don't
question, what was in the fried rice?
The normal, like peas, carrots, eggs, and
ham?
Yeah, ham.
Gotcha. Not spam? The Chinese way is spam. That's how we roll here on the West Coast. That's a West Coast thing. Yeah. I remember sitting there one day and I was in a Japanese.
And now it's a fried rice and chicken.
You make it with spam. It's so good with spam. If you're gonna eat, I'm telling you, chop up some spam, add it to your fried rice. In a can, comes in a.
It's like a solid block of like processed ground up meat in a solid corn.
Do you eat hot dogs?
Yes.
That's the same damn thing.
But then,
a hot dog is basically spam called a hot dog. I mean, they don't taste the same. Spam is more hammy than a hot dog. I don't even know what the flavor of a hot dog is.
Gotta go.
Notice I'm much more professional now. I don't say, hey, what's that? Check this out. Watch it. Mr. Wallace. Hi. You've got to take me back to the history. Did they want it? Then why are we pushing? Right. But if they didn't, I mean, if that's what they chose, then why are we, you know what I mean? Right. Oh, you. I mean, how do you want to do it? I mean, you know, if you want me to do it, I can do the subtle approach or I don't know your relationship with them, so I can't speak to them. Oh, okay, well then probably as long as I don't put down the Patriots, I'm good with that. As far as mom, my thing is this. If someone says if a parent tells me we don't want this, then I just don't do it. You know, unless I see it as a health and safety issue. They need to hear that. And Carrington of that, and if anybody, and I think that they should hear, you're the professional here. You're the expert. I mean, if you think that it would help, they need to hear the reason why, whereas, I'll just say, hey, she said she qualifies, but maybe they need to hear the specific reasons why. And she agreed to it at that time. Right. Present the case, and they can say yes or no. And if they say no, I check, we're done. Right. I'm always hoping that people are going to say, we don't want you anymore. I'm saying, hey, one less IEP. It's a less paperwork for me. I know. No, I hear you. No, I think it's at the meeting, you know, you just say, now, here's some, the other thing that I was wondering is, if you think that they're just going to say no to it, if that's what you're asking, and so why should you be there? If you'd rather do that over the phone, so that you don't have, okay, that'd be my greater concern. So we're trying to storm out of that? Here is what I will tell you. If they don't want it, they're going to tell you no. They have no problem with that. Trust me. Yeah. But if things are going to be handed out to people across the room and stuff, you make sure you provide something for everyone or don't do it. Wait until the passing period to give them specific.
Thank you, though.
Yeah. And I think it's great. And again, I acknowledge your right to do what you want, but I'm not comfortable with that in my class. Okay? That makes sense? Well, I mean, I think about that, right? Like, you're going to call someone from across the room to come and get something, and then, you know, like, how does that make everybody else feel, you know?
Yeah.
And the world, I mean, the world works how it works, but I just think that, you know, I think that if you're going to do something like that, it's like when I bring in food, I don't just, I mean, sometimes when I only have one item and can't split it up, I'll pick one person, and then I'll promise other people, hey, you'll get it the next day. Or I pick that thing up and I divide it and I try to give everybody something. I go out of my way to do that. It's called being equitable. Yes. I saw your hand. Do you have a comment?
I have a comment on this.
Sure.
Wait, no, a question then.
Sure, ask.
I know I see your point, but do you think, is it, like, your point is that you're like, you don't want anyone to feel bad about it, right?
What I want is this, like, when you look at the big picture, you come into someone's class, and this is our class, right?
Yeah.
But I also oversee, like, how the class runs. So if I want it to be chaotic, I'll let it be chaotic. If I want it to be focused, I'm going to make it focused. Okay. So when you're giving out something, when you bring in food like that, I want you to imagine, put yourself in other people's shoes. When you see food being handed out, especially something like donuts, do you desire to have some yourself? And if you were left out, would that make you feel bad? Yeah.
Not really.
Not really? And that's fine. You like me, I don't care. Like if someone's eating donuts and I don't get out of it, I really won't care. But I also know that if I go into a situation...
But he'll give you crap for it.
Yeah, because I'm obnoxious.
Yes.
But that's different. Okay. But like, but I also know that there are probably other people who do care. Okay. So if you come in with food in a classroom, especially amongst teenagers love to eat, and they especially love sweets, and you're going to start handing things out individually, I want you to think about like, how could that make other people feel?
Are we eating rounds?
We are, but he asked a question, so I'm answering it. And you guys created this situation. It was actually Ty Ty who created the situation, who called you up and asked you to come over to get something. Well, I'm not saying you're a bad person for it, and I'm just saying you created the situation. Regardless of what, you could have turned around and said, well, would you do it yourself? Or you could have said, you know, I don't know if Wallace would want me to do that, so no. So...
You know, like my mom, we like sometimes I'll tell her a joke and then she'll make it into a whole lecture. Yeah, I hate that.
Okay, but I don't see this as a joke.
I know it's not.
Right, this is different. Yeah. Okay. So I guess it's all about just being respectful of everybody's feelings within a class. Being respectful to my class since I'm the teacher, and I wouldn't want this disruption to happen. So here's the other thing too, here's the logic of it all. If you're gonna create a disruption and it's about handing out donuts, you better have one for everybody. That makes sense? Or else don't go there. Does that explain it? Maybe that's the simplest way to explain it. Okay, all right. Are you finished, chicken fried rice lady?
I'm finished.
Devin?
I'm a 10-year-old.
Are you a lady? Are you a lady?
No.
So I was talking to a lady. Okay. Devin? Right. Well, there are people who weren't here during first period. Tell them what you had to make up. By the way, would anyone like a mint? You can't have one. Okay. Go ahead, you had two cheeseburgers and what else? And a french fry. Andrew? Well, you had top ramen and top of tea.
Yeah.
But with the popcorn, did you put it in the top ramen?
No.
I've added to my top ramen, seriously, in the past, Fritos, to give the soft a little crunch. Okay. Oh, you guys have done that?
Yeah.
That kind of thing?
Or like with a thick soup or like a chili, I'll eat the chili, but the chili Fritos.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh, I just had a moment. Thank you. Tai Tai, how about you?
A smoothie.
Ooh, what kind of smoothie?
Strawberry, banana, coconut. And carrots.
What was the juice? Was it, well, made with orange juice and all of those?
Juice and coconut.
Yeah. Sounds good. Was it a homemade one?
Yeah.
Was that it?
And a taco with coffee.
Okay.
It was like a brisket taco.
Brisket, that just, ooh, I just felt that. Okay. That sounds good. A ribeye steak. All right. That's my favorite steak. Anything more? Almost spitting out this damn bit. Anything else with it? Salad, french fries, anything like that? Baked potato?
A salad.
A salad? This is homemade. What kind of dressing? This ranch? Dai Chi? What you reading there, Dai Chi? Oh, you're doing a... He's doing a word sleuth.
Word search?
Yeah, I call them word sleuths. But yeah, word search. A word sleuth? Do you know what a sleuth is?
Yeah.
Is that called, does that say word sleuth on it? Back in my day, those were called, the title would be word sleuth, not search.
That's called word puzzle.
Okay. Well, see, to me, a word puzzle is any category of things like crossword puzzles, word loops, or word searches, anagrams, things like
that. Okay, you're pointing.
Well, because you like seem to have an issue with this. Like, I wonder where you get that at. Oh, I know where you get that.
All right, yeah, my mom.
So you gonna tell us what you had for dinner last night? You're just gonna sit there and ignore me after I give you a bit.
I'm waiting for you to be done.
Oops. Go with that.
I don't remember what I had on.
Jesus. Go through all that just to be told. Alright, fine. Tyler?
I didn't have anything.
Okay. That's 2 days in a row.
Actually, that's like 5 days in a row.
5 days in a row? So you don't, I take it you don't eat dinner.
Yeah.
You're not really into the whole dinner thing, you're more into the breakfast and lunch thing.
Yeah.
You do like a late night snack?
Once in a while.
Once in a while? You didn't do a late night snack last night?
Yeah.
Okay. Ryan, what did you have for dinner last night?
Chicken nuggets and French fries.
With ketchup, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
You okay there?
Yeah. You know how if you swallow like some sugar or something, that's really... I had Papa Murphy's pizza. I got a pan pizza, and I had
a hand pizza.
Hand.
Oh.
I don't know why I went like that. Yeah. I realized, like, why did I do that? That doesn't. Does that form a pan? I guess I should have done it like this. Yeah, I don't know why I used my hand to. I like to use my. You know, I had a student one time. Their mom came here. The student got in trouble, so the mom came here and talked, you know, to me, and then left. And then the next day, the student says, "Hey, Mr. Wells, my mom thinks you're gay." And I said, oh, "Okay. Why does she think that?" And she says, "Well, because you use your hands when you talk." And I said, "What do you mean?" She goes, "Well, when you talk, you're always going like this." And I said, "Oh, and like the other guys in the class were like, what?" Everybody talks like that. She goes, well, she thought that the way Wallace did it was really gay. And I said, all right. So I said, would that change the way you feel about me? Like, and she goes, no. I thought good for you. Anyway. I had a pan pizza. And in the pan pizza, here's how. I have a Chicago style. Cheese first on the crust. Then the veggies, and I had tomato, fresh garlic, and mushroom sauce on top. Then you bake it. That's what makes a Chicago style pizza a Chicago style pizza.
So
not only in the pan, but the sauce is on top. And it kind of, and what it does is it keeps all of the ingredients moist. So like the mushrooms and the tomato don't get dried out. Right, you ever eat a pizza with like tomato, mushroom, or like spinach on top and it's burnt?
Yeah.
It's all dried up and shriveled up. Pan pizzas, this doesn't happen. Everything stays really moist. And then the cheese really bakes into the crust. So they're not really stringy and stuff. It's... The lady at Papa Murphy's says that she does this now every time. And so there's a new guy there. Do you want the sauce on top? Are you sure? She goes, yeah. She goes, that's the only way I eat my pizza now. She said she took one home and she said she showed her family. They're like, what the hell is this? Where's the cheese? And she goes, listen, you gotta try this. This guy who comes into our store does this. We're gonna try it. They tried it. She said her whole family, that's the only kind of pizza they order now. So, SID, what do you guys want to talk about?
The kids.
What do you guys want to talk about?
Excluding
guns. What about guns?
I thought the news they're saying that they're trying to not allow guns, but they're saying that they're not really.
They want to ban AR-15s, assault rifles. Okay, question. Show of hands. How many of you are
Ryan?
Ryan. Where the hell is he going?
He's freaking red. He's like, red.
Dark.
Dude, you can't do that.
Ted, don't do it, dude.
Okay, Ryan, look at me. Do you want me to call your parents?
No.
Okay, so listen.
door. Let's swipe it. Let's
if
hit the
you
door
don't
up.
Want me to do that, you have to stop yeah. running at yeah. people.
Yeah.
Because you scare them when you run at them like that.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
You got it?
Yeah.
Dude, you gotta stop that.
Yeah.
Because it freaks people out.
Yeah.
Okay? It's okay to say hi to people, but you can't run at them.
Yeah.
Alright?
Yeah. No, don't call my parents.
I won't call your parents as long as you stop running at people.
Yeah.
Okay? Otherwise, we're gonna have to have a meeting. So.
No!
Alright. So stop running at people.
Yeah.
Alright.
Kyle, mind the meeting.
Then don't run at them. We're okay now. That's not helping. The hell was I talking about?
Yes.
So, show of hands. Excuse me. Oh, hey, Daichi, would you put that away, please?
Yeah.
Hold on. Hold on. That's what I wanted.
I just found one.
Hold on. You know what? This would not do well if I was a cop. Put that down, sir. Yeah, hold on.
Wrong answer.
Hold on. No, you hold on. You Pepsi drinking.
Oh, here's Trevor.
Here's Trevor. Oh, crap. That was weird. Show of hands. How many of you think, be honest, let's see, in this classroom, how many of you think assault rifles should be banned? Raise your hand if you think assault rifles, those types of weapons should be banned. Okay, I have a question. Devin and Nico. Neither of you think that assault weapons should be banned. Did you not hear my question? Okay. Why? Tell me the reason why you don't think they should be banned. Why should we allow people to purchase assault rifles like an AR-15, an M-16, an AK-47? Why do you think we should be allowed to do that? See, the nature of education, guys, that I want you guys to do is, I'm not here to get to force you to adopt an opinion, okay? But what I am here to do is to get you guys to question the nature of your beliefs, to question the information that, like, why do you think what you think? Why do you believe what you believe? What drives it? And then, for example, if you say to me, I don't know, then what I hope you would do is like ask yourself later, you don't have to do it here, but you ask them, well, why do I believe this? Like, is there a logic to it? I'm going to give you guys an example. Okay, you two who believe that we should be, I have a friend who is a hunter, and who believes in the Second Amendment, and who believes that the government shouldn't tell them what kind of guns, but who says no one should be allowed to buy an assault rifle. There's no point in having one. There's no point as a hunter. There's much better guns as a hunter to have. As a that gun is used, the idea of the gun is for mass killing, to kill people quickly. Okay? And that's, you know, if you want home defense, have a shotgun, have a pistol. You want to hunt, get a rifle.
Yeah.
There is no point in having an assault weapon. That's why he's against it. He said, look, I'm a member of the NRA. This is him talking, not me. He's a member of the NRA, and yet he does not agree with the NRA. He does not. He said he would vote against, he would vote for an assault weapon thing. Now, he wouldn't vote for more regulations. He says they've already regulated us enough. We don't need more regulations when it comes to me buying a gun. I believe I should register. I don't have a problem with that. I don't think I should have to wait that long, though. It should go quicker through the FBI database. I don't think I should be able to use lead bullets. Okay. Now, at the same time, he says, I would vote against assault weapons. So why do you guys, can you give me one reason? So the class, who all thinks that they should be banned, can you give one reason why they shouldn't be banned? I'm giving you guys a chance to speak out here.
Because
you have a reason? Okay. Do you have a reason? Okay. When you're ready, raise your hand and let us know. We'll come back to it. Okay. So, what other than that? So it seems like the majority of you. I have a question for you guys. Did the shooting in Florida, since that day, did it make you think more about guns, or have you always?
Yeah.
It was the shooting that made you think more about that?
There's been a lot of shootings in the past year.
Yeah, true. There wasn't just Parkland. There are a lot of shootings in a lot of different places. You guys know there's a shooting recently at YouTube, right?
Yeah.
You guys heard about that?
Yeah.
Interesting. Before the lady, I think her name is Nassim, I don't remember her last name. Before she went in and shot up YouTube and then shot herself, there was a police interaction. They said,
"What was Amazon?
A normal
YouTube?"
No, it was a YouTube.
Yeah.
There was a police interaction 3 hours earlier, and the police in that city, I don't know what city it is, the police are not releasing their body cam videos of it. Now, in government, we're supposed to be transparent. I find that kind of suspicious. But they probably have a right not to. There's reasons why, you know, they say that there are good reasons why, you know, to protect other people, why they don't show body cam footage. But this seems kind of odd that you have an interaction where a person isn't arrested. What is it you're hiding? Because it sounds like you're hiding something if you're not going to release it. But obviously she was that. Then the belief is that she was so agitated from her police interaction that was a trigger, that set her off.
Oh, no. They were demonetizing her videos for sensitive content.
Okay.
So that's why she was pissed.
Did she work at YouTube?
No, she had a YouTube channel. But they were demonetizing her videos because of sensitive content and stuff. But
so then she went to the YouTube headquarters and shot. That's heavy, man. That is heavy. I grew up in an era where fights, anger, things like that, they were settled with fists for the most part. Yeah, there were shootings, but man, and now it just seems... I'll tell you what, though. I don't know if you guys know this. What do you guys think, though? Okay, so I graduated from high school in 1983.
Stop!
I wouldn't have done it. I thought you were looking at it to see if that's what caused it.
That I know that that was the problem.
Okay. So question. Ryan?
Dora.
Remember?
Yeah.
Ryan.
Dora.
Ryan, don't run at people and don't yell Dora at them. That you know that was a teacher?
Yeah.
Who just walked by?
Yeah, that was?
Yeah. That was a teacher who just walked by.
No.
You okay?
Okay.
Okay. Cool. Why don't you put on your headphones and do some reading? Question to you guys. Do you think that there are per capita that the murder rate is higher today or the murder rate higher when I was in high school? What do you guys
today.
Think?
Today.
What do you guys think?
Wow.
Yeah. The murder rate was higher when I was in high school, per capita. America has fewer murders overall. That doesn't mean it's not going up in certain areas. I'll give you an example. New York City, when I was in high school in the 1980s, there was one year where they had over 2,000 murders. Last year, they had under 300 murders in New York City. That's a huge decline. Now, the question, why do you guys think that you believe it's higher? Okay, well, there were more guns. I mean, there were just as many guns back when I was around. Why do you guys think that you think the murder rate is higher? Here, let me ask you this, Ty. How do you know there's more guns? It's everywhere, but on the news.
And the news makes it sound like a big thing.
Libby, you're supposed to put away your phone. I said you could have a headphone on, one. But the phone is, put it on a song or put it on a radio station and leave
I'm
it
done skipping.
So So do you think that you guys think the murder rate is higher because the media sensationalizes things like murder? You know, oh, cool. No, good. I think that I agree with you. Guys, earlier today in class, somebody asked, was it first period where the people said, yeah, it was first period, Ernesto, or I think it was Ernesto, it doesn't matter. They said, look, there's a lot of suicides. How come TV doesn't, why doesn't the media talk about all the suicides? Okay? And so my question was, or my response to it, it was Sam who brought it up, was that because the topic of suicide isn't sexy. Well, and Sam said, because the media always talks about rapes and murder and terrorist acts and all these things, that's all we hear about. But they don't talk about suicides, and there's people who are dying. And I said, you're absolutely right. They don't focus on suicides. When you turn on the TV, if there's a terrorist attack, you'll hear about it the rest of the week until the new flavor comes out. If there's a murder, a school shooting, you'll hear about it. And that doesn't mean that those things shouldn't be on the news. But those are the things, that's what sells advertising. But here's the data, Libby. And this is what's driving police. There's a lot of paranoia, and that's why police are shooting. See, you guys know who Stephon Clark is, right? He was the guy who was killed in South Sac. Who was killed in South Sac by police. He was unarmed, shot 8 times. And there are some people who say that that is a black and white issue. I happen to think that it could have been anyone. I think the police are so paranoid about being shot at and about a bad guy having guns. And I think a lot of this has to do with the media. Because who are the police? What animal are the police? They're human beings too. Do the police watch TV when they go home?
No.
You don't think they watch TV when they go home? You don't think they put on the news? Well, they do. Because what are they again?
The man from the
age. They're human beings. They're human beings.
Well, that's true.
So do you think that the media affects them?
Yeah.
That if I'm a cop, right, I'm a human being, and all I hear about, I turn on the computer, and the first thing that appears on my screen is the world's going to come to an end, and there's murders and every, you know. And then I turn off my computer, and I turn on the radio, and talk radio, they're talking about, like, murders and stuff. Okay, I turn on the news, I turn on the station, and there's murders on there. What am I going to think? You believe there are more guns out. You think that the murder rate's higher. The reality is, it's not. Murder rates are actually lower in the United States. What's that?
The school shootings in your time?
There were, I don't remember, like, the first major school shooting was Columbine in Colorado. That was the first major one. I had never heard of anyone going into a school and shooting up a school.
See, that's what I'm saying. Right now, they
are. But here's the thing, right? School shootings, that doesn't mean, though, Ty, that, are you looking at your phone right now?
No.
Okay. It doesn't mean that the murder rate is higher. You understand what I'm saying? Like, definitely school shootings are much more common. It almost seems like they're happening about once a month, would you say? That's definitely what's happening. They were happening almost daily, if not weekly. What did they say? Before Parkland, there were 33 school shootings. I'm sorry, 33 mass shootings. You guys know what makes a mass shooting? Any shooting that involves more than 4 people being shot. Okay? Any shooting that involves more than 4 people being shot, they're a mass shooting. We didn't have that many, I don't remember, in the world. But here's the crazy thing, guys. The murder rate was higher per capita when Sacramento, at one time in Time Magazine, was the murder capital of the United States. In the 1980s, we had the most amount of murders per capita in the United States. That's mind-boggling. Here's the thing about murders, though, okay? Most murders happen within your own circle. I think I've told you guys this before. The data shows you're probably not going to get blown up by a terrorist who comes across our border illegally. Most likely, if you're going to die, it's going to come at the hands of someone you know. Someone that you associate with, or a family member, or an ex-boyfriend or girlfriend, or current boyfriend or girlfriend, or husband or wife, something like that. There were murders here. I'm going to tell you two people. There are two people I know from my class who committed murder. One of the people murdered his wife.
Right now?
Yeah, this was about 10 years ago that it happened. That I know of. Two people from my class. And another person murdered his parents, both of his parents. Shot him in bed while they were sleeping. Terrorists didn't get him. Both of them were white. A black guy from South Sac didn't kill him. You know what I'm saying? That's the reality. But people are paranoid. They're scared. They're afraid of illegal immigrants who are criminals who are flooding across the border. They're afraid of Islamic extremists who are going to kill them. The data shows you're going to get killed by somebody you know if you get killed. I told you guys, I tell you this before, I taught a class in a prison. It was in Chillicothe, Ohio. And I was teaching at a little college called Chatfield College, a little private Catholic college in southwestern Ohio. And they needed someone to cover this workshop. Okay, so I said, I'll do it. So they paid for my expense, and I went out there, and the warden took me aside, and we're walking through the gates and stuff, and they're explaining to me. By the way, says, I don't know what your preconceived notions are of people in prison. He says, but what you got to understand is you don't have to worry about them. I mean, unless you piss them off, they're not. They got no beef with you. In fact, he said, most of them appreciate the fact that you're willing to come in here and teach, okay? They might test you. They might mess with you. But they have no reason to attack you. He says, most of the people who are in prison killed someone they knew. They didn't go out and kill some stranger for the hell of it. They didn't freak out on drugs and mow down people on the street. They killed someone they knew. Typically, there was some drugs involved. Either they were high at the time, or it was a drug deal gone bad, or they were stealing drugs from someone, or someone stole drugs from them. But they killed someone they knew. That's the reality. And yet, we're very paranoid about, why do we want assault rifles? Do we want to mow down all these people who are coming from another neighborhood for us? Listen, they haven't come for us yet. They're probably not going to come for us tomorrow. Do you need an assault rifle to kill someone standing next to you? Because that's the person that is probably going to get you. Kind of mind-boggling. And then again, what makes us think that we have to worry about the rest of society? The media. But again, you guys can check the statistics. Look at the statistics for murder rate in the United States. Again, per capita. There are more people in the United States than when I was a kid. So there's going to be higher numbers of people killed. But statistically speaking, per capita, the percentages are much, much, much lower. And yet, we feel this society, this country, is much, much more violent. Another SIV topic. Throw something out there. Somebody else. I'll ask you guys personal questions. I'm going to call on you, and I want you to think about this right now. Tell me one thing about you. I want to learn about you. Tell me one thing that you think that I don't know about you already. Tell me one thing that I might find interesting. Think about that. And that you're willing to share. You know, I don't want someone to say, Mr. Wallace, I have four nipples on my back. No. That'd be kind of weird. You don't have to tell us that. Although if you want to tell us that, that's fine. Think of one thing you can tell. Obviously, you're going to be telling the class. What's one thing about you that nobody knows that they might find interesting? I'm kind of an open book. You guys have probably two damn questions about me. You got one?
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
When I was really little, when me and my mom went to the craft store, I would steal little charms.
You were a thief.
Yeah.
You're a little fucker. That's awesome. You know what?
But I was like six, so.
Very tough. I used to steal too. Did you ever get caught?
No.
I got caught. Anybody steal as a little kid and get caught? What happened to you?
I was not little.
Okay.
I got scared.
Okay.
Like, it was like, pretty bad, we're going to call the cops. There's so many cameras around me. I would make mistakes. Let them see me on the camera.
Do you guys know what Mervyn's is? Do you guys know what Kohl's is?
Yeah.
K-O-H-L-S. That Kohl's over there by Art and Fair Mall, that used to be Mervyn's. Kohl's took over Mervyn's. So Kohl's was a store like Mervyn's in the Midwest, and they bought out Mervyn's, and now they're in. Okay. So it was Mervyn's, right? When I was about 8 years old, I stole these figurines. Iron Man, Captain America, and stuff, and I stuffed them in my socks. So I used to wear tube socks up to here, right? Everybody did that in the 70s. So I took, like,
Were you wearing long pants?
And I was wearing long pants.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because I was about to be like, if you're
wearing
shorts.
There's pictures of me wearing shorts with tube socks. That was the 70s.
No, no, no. I'm saying, like, if you were wearing shorts with the tube socks, you had them in there.
No. Long pants. So what happened is I'm walking kind of funny, and my mom's like, what's going on with you? And we're walking out to the car. I'm like, oh, my leg kind of hurts. And she's like, okay, I didn't notice your leg hurting when we walked in. I said, oh, yeah, I did. Twisted my ankle. And she's like, okay. So we get in the car, and she's looking at me. She keeps looking at my legs, and she goes, hey, you know, there's a hand sticking out of your leg. And there's this little plastic hand, little pink hand sticking out. I'm like, she goes, what's that? And I said, I don't know. I kind of covered up. She goes, lift up your pant leg. I'm like, no. Then I lift up, my pant leg, and all these, like, superheroes fall out.
Oh, no.
So she goes, you stole those, didn't you? And I'm like, yeah. And she goes, wait here. I'm going to go in and take this back. So she went into the store and she came back and she said, the manager wants to talk to you. Now, here's what I didn't know. My mom went in, told the manager what happened. And she said, the manager was like, oh, it's okay. You know, blah, blah. She goes, no, I need to steer him straight. So we're going to come back. And you're going to call the police, get on the phone and pretend like you're calling the police. I'm going to beg you not to. And you're going to insist on, and we're going to get him. We want to break him. And then and the manager like, okay, I'll play along. So my mom says, I'm sorry, but the manager wants to talk to you. And I'm not getting through. I'm like, no. She goes, come on, we have to go in. And so we go in. And it's like, all right, well, he says, your mom returned the stuff. And he says, I need to let you know that I have to call the police. And so it's store policy. Like, but sir, we brought him back. My mom's like, sir, please don't call the police. I brought them back, and blah, 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 blah. We can't go to jail, because if he goes to jail, they'll arrest me, too. He goes, well, I'm sorry. I guess they have to arrest you, too, ma'am. So, like, ah! I start crying. Don't call the police on me! And I was like, are you sure? And my mom's like, please, officer, or please. Please don't call the police. My mom's pretending like she's crying, and I'm like, freak out. Finally, guy's like, hello, sir, is this the police? That's how you talk to the police. He's like, yes, I have this young man, and so he's talking, and he goes, wait 1 second, please. And he says, and he looks at me, he goes, you promise to never do this again? I promise! He's like, okay, excuse me, officer, we've decided we're not going to press charges. And they hang up, and I'm like, ooh, and I walk out, and I probably have PTSD to this day from that. And then we get home. And then later on, when I'm a teenager, I'm like, that was mean, Mom. But then I got arrested a couple times when I was in middle school.
For what? Mr. Wallace?
That shall remain.
So when I graduate, can I come back and ask you?
I'll tell you when you graduate.
Okay.
Yeah. I should say this. I had the police called on me when I was at Arden Middle School.
Okay.
Twice at Arden and once. My stepfather, I'll tell you a story. My stepfather was a cop. I told you guys that.
Oh, so you got your dad called
her. No, it wasn't my dad. These were actual cops. This is Sacramento Sheriff. They had nothing, and he was Sac PD. So my stepdad comes home one day, and he has this police report, right?
Oh, boy.
And he's in uniform. And I'm thinking, man, Al, that's my stepdad. He's never here at this time, you know? And he walks in, he's like talking to my mom, and all of a sudden the two of them come up. I'm sitting in my room, you know, I'm like listening to music and stuff. And my mom says, Al wants to talk to you about something.
Did she like her lips like that too? She's like,
that was me. So my stepdad starts reading this police report. And he mentioned, so the person who's been arrested is my friend, who that morning, he and I had done something. So he starts reading the police report. Now, my friend went to his middle school. He went to Sutter Middle School.
Oh, that's right.
And I was at Arden. Right. So my mom did not want me to go to Sutter, because when I was in middle school, Sutter was a really bad school. It was a rough inner city downtown school, okay? It's very different now. And so she bought a house, that's where we live now, out in Arden Park. So we were living in East Sac, but I was going to school at Arden Middle School. So he reads this report, says, suspect number one, who's my friend, doesn't know the name of the other suspect, but it says, suspect is wearing, and it describes all of the clothes. And I'm sitting there wearing all of these clothes, right? And didn't know the last name, first name is Jason. Suspect is 13 years old, lives in East Sacramento, has this description of me. Only known name, Jason. And my stepdad looks at me and goes, who does this sound like? I'm like, like, what do you say? It's like, you know, I was like,
What do you do?
When you graduate, and as long as you're 18, I'll tell you. I was just into shenanigans that a lot of 12, 13-year-old boys who lived in DSAC with it. You know,
I used to rock people. Just kidding.
That wasn't unheard of where I grew up. You know, we used to do a lot of crazy things, man. And here I am this day, there but for the grace of God. Luckily, I wasn't killed. I didn't kill anyone. I didn't get into too much trouble.
I almost went to jail once.
It's literally 5 minutes more. Can I go? You can spare 5 minutes for me.
Yeah, you guys can chill out. Or unless you guys want to continue SID. Yeah, you may go. Have a nice weekend.
Oh, yeah, it's Friday.
It is.
It's
my
first time
staying there.
It's okay.
The rest of you, hey, did you ever come up with your reason why you think automatic weapons or assault rifles shouldn't be banned? I don't mean it like that. You are entitled to your opinion. You realize that, right? I'm not attacking it. I just want to hear why you think that it should be.
I don't think it wouldn't matter. It's just you know, it just convert the weapons to automatic.
Well, you know, okay, so one of those conversions is the bump stock. And you know those are illegal, right? That doesn't mean people can't get them, but they're illegal. And it's pretty, so most of those attacks were committed with automatic rifles. They weren't converted non-automatic rifles. Semi-automatic weapons. The thing about assault rifles, Nico, is that the clips that come with them usually give the shooter way more bullets. And that they're able to discharge them quickly. And that's like a big deal. If you want to wipe out a lot of people. B14. Hi. I'm doing great. Thank you. Right. I did. As far as like talking to him about who he hangs out with, yeah, I'm not going to go there. I think he'll be fine. He's doing his math in here and it's dragging out, but he's getting it done. I believe he's over 40%. He knows, and I can get him to, get him to turn it on pretty quickly. English, just between you and I right now, we see we'll do it. Yeah, because here's the thing, when he was failing last time, I said, I'm going to pull him and put him in my car. He said, no, I'd rather have him in here. He got the problem with girls producing work, turning in and that, but she really likes it. So that's kind of where she's at. So, we don't want to tell him, like, I don't, I want him on the edge, a lot of the friends. So I don't want to tell him, like, hey, that's cool, we see the past, absolutely which I have, I plan on, I was going to do it during you guys have any SID, anything else? Tyler, you usually like, you got nothing? No. Nothing you want to say or discuss or throw out there? No. Got you?
Something you probably wouldn't expect about me.
Oh, yeah, I want to hear that. Sit down. Let's hear you. What's something, one fact about you that nobody knows?
During freshman year, I tried a few drugs with Jovi and never, hardly ever come back home. And policemen found me somewhere at a park late at night. And he put me in a jail cell for about 5 nights. My mom came to pick me up in the morning.
Wow. Yeah, I mean, that's a common teenage story, so I'm not surprised.
Yeah,
that happens.
I regret doing that, though.
So you discovered that drugs aren't the answer?
No, I didn't do it because I wanted to do it. I just did it because everyone else was doing it. And I regret it if I never stopped.
Have you guys ever done anything because everyone else does it, but then you wish you hadn't done it?
No.
No? So you're not really a follower, you don't give into peer pressure?
Not really.
Not really? Okay.
I usually don't, but that time I did.
That time you did?
I was just very frustrated with everything at that point, so.
Was it early on in high school?
Yeah, it was not just high school, it was home issues and everything, so I shouldn't care anymore, because I'm just going to do this.
Yeah.
So, I didn't do it necessarily to be a follower, although I did kind of try to fit in with it, but I didn't do it to be a follower.
You just wanted to step outside of yourself for a brief time?
Yeah.
Sounds like you stepped really far outside of yourself. Yeah. You got thrown into a cell.
Yeah.
You must have been kind of out of your mind at that moment, huh?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Well, thank you for sharing that. Thank you for the lesson. Hopefully you guys hear that. Where are you going? Class ain't over. He was talking, man.
Yeah, no. You want to go over there.
Go over where?
To the sports period.
You can't wait until the damn bell rings?
No, I can't wait.
You got to get up in the middle of someone talking?
No, we don't get it.
What don't I get?
Never mind. I don't want to explain it. I just need to go.
Okay, go.
Yeah.
I hear it. Try next weekend.
Thank you.
Man, I think that's it.
Devin, how about you? Oh, hold on, guys. I got one thing to say.
Oh, God. That's funny. I think your butt liked my story.
I don't want you to think about my butt liking you. Nico, how about you? You got a factoid about yourself that you might find surprising?